and our challenges, and there have been plenty of both. Overall, though, I'm very proud of the great care, innovation and collaboration that our nearly 11,000 staff continue to demonstrate. In the first part of the evening, our new Chief Executive, Ian Dalton, will begin with an overview of our performance for the year, and then our Chief Financial Officer, Richard Alexander, will follow with a presentation of our financial accounts. Both will take a brief look forward to our future plans. We will then open up the meeting to half an hour of questions and answers, where we will also be joined on stage by our Medical Director, Director of Nursing, and our three Clinical Directors. In the second part of the evening, we will have a short presentation followed by questions on exciting developments in digital technology that are enabling patients, clinicians, and other healthcare and care staff to use the power of information to improve individual and population health. The formal part of the event will end at 7:15, but there will be at least another half hour where you can meet and talk with our directors, senior managers, clinicians, more informally, and take a look probably at the information stands at the back. Our finances will feature significantly throughout the evening. Our deficit position is not sustainable, and we're working very hard to navigate a route back to financial health. This is a task we have in common, of course, with many other NHS trusts across the country. The bigger focus, though, will be on how we are continuing to build on the great care, innovation and education that our staff provide across our five hospitals and, increasingly, in the community. Events such as this one are very important in allowing us to share our views and thinking, and I hope encouraging the collaborative working that we need to ensure the best way forward. I'm extremely grateful to all our staff, supporters and volunteers, and our partners in the NHS, local authority and voluntary sectors for all their hard work and commitment in achieving what we can for our patients and local communities. I would also like to express our gratitude to Dr. Tracy Batten, our former Chief Executive, who left the Trust at the end of July. Many of you have met Tracy. She made an enormous contribution to the Trust, in particular to the development of a much more open and enabling organisational culture. And now, I'm very pleased to welcome our new Chief Executive, Ian Dalton. I'm delighted that we continue to attract the highest calibre of leader. Ian brings extensive leadership experience, gained in very senior roles within the NHS, and also in the wider healthcare sector. His deep understanding of the NHS and the wider public services, combined with his track record of running complex organisations and his commitment to innovation and collaboration, will enable us to really build on our achievements of recent years. On that note, I will hand over to Ian for our first